Students, yesterday we had started with the chapter, the 100 dresses, the first part of the two chapters that we have. And what had we read about? We had read about this school, and three girls in particular have been discussed in this chapter. One of them is Wanda Petronsky. Wanda Petronsky was a Polish immigrant, and immigrant people are people who have settled in another country, right? And in America, there are lots of people who have gone there, settled there for better life, for better opportunities. And we have a large Polish population in the city of Chicago. Okay. Now, Wanda Petronsky had not reached school that day. Right. And two girls there, who were they? Maddie and Peggy. They realized her absence. How did they realize her absence? Because they used to wait for her outside the school. And for that day, they were late to the class. And they had kept on waiting for her. She did not come. And when they reached the class, they were late. Okay. Now, Wanda Petronsky was a very quiet girl. Where would she sit in the classroom? She would sit in the corner where the rough boys were there. Like, of course, yeah. Well, the rough boys, the boys who talked a lot, who shouted a lot, who made a lot of noise. And she would sit over there. But she was not a noisy person. She was not a talkative person. No, she was a very good girl. She went and sat over there, and she would just sit there quietly, attend the classes, and go back home. She came from a place called Boggins Heights. And it was not one of, you can say, the posh areas. And by the time she would reach school, and especially during the rainy weather and all, her feet would become muddy, and she would go and sit at the back of the class, right? And here, now what was it? That these two girls, they were there, that is Maddie and Peggy, they were waiting for her. Every day they would wait for her and they would ask her questions, right? Why do you think they behaved like this with her? Because Wanda was different. She had a name which was unlike the names which are very common and popular in the United States. So Wanda Petronsky. And as I told you, sometimes, or not sometimes, I would say many times, you know, we have our own judgments, we have our own assumptions that we have. And one of them is how we behave with people. We look at them, we judge people by their appearance. We judge people by their names. We judge people by the color of their skin, right? And if we feel we are not comfortable with that person, if that person does not look like us, talk like us, behave like us, we are very bad, you know, because we have a great difficulty in accepting that person. And if it is in the classroom, when you find that someone is different, you start calling that person maybe names, you start ignoring that person, you isolate that person, or maybe sometimes you give that person too much of attention, you know, asking about him, about his appearance, about his name, about his dress, and it continues day after day, making the situation very unpleasant for that child, right? So you might not know it, but yes, when you are there, you know, showing a strength over someone who is new or who is shorter than you or weaker than you, and you're trying to show your authority, you're bullying that person, which is not a nice thing to do, right? Now, let us see, as I'm going to proceed with this chapter, we're going to discuss about inclusion. We're going to talk about diversity. We will also discuss about bullying. And our country, as you know, it is known for its diversity. But in spite of that diversity, we have a lot of problem in accepting people who are not like us, right? And why does it happen? Because we have these stereotypes, we have these judgmental opinions about them. We are not ready to accept people who do not look like us, which is a very wrong thing. So hope by the end of this chapter, we will become better people. We will understand about inclusion. We will understand about diversity. We will understand about bullying. Now, let's have a look at the questions we had discussed. Yes, so we have the three girls, that is Wanda Petronsky. There was Peggy and Maddie. And these girls, they just waited for her before the school or after the school to have fun with her. What does to have fun with her mean? To tease her, right? And of course, for them, it was something funny. They would laugh at it, but they did not know they were making that child very, very uncomfortable. Wanda Petronsky. Most of the children in room 13 did not have names like that. They had names easy to say, like Thomas, Smith, Alan, right? So people had these kinds of names, and Wanda Petronsky, the name itself was different. There was one boy named Bounce, Willie Bounce, and people thought that was funny, but not funny in the same way that Petronsky was. Petronsky is a very different name, right? Wanda did not have any friends. Very sad. Imagine you go to school and you don't have friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She did not walk to school with her friends, and she did not have any friends whom she could walk back home to. She always wore a faded blue dress that didn't hang right. Hang right? It did not fit her properly. Maybe it was not of her size. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. So the dress was clean, but faded. It did not fit her, and it was not also ironed regularly. She didn't have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. Once again, just like remember in the chapter Anne Frank, Anne talked to many girls. She was very talkative, but she did not have a friend. Here also, yes, the girls of the class, they did talk to her, but it did not come specially that, okay, this is my friend, I have to talk to her. Not that way. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the worn, hard ground. So sometimes the girls would come and stand around her when she was standing in the playground and looking at the girls playing hopscotch. Right? Hopscotch, like you have your step hoop. Okay? Have you ever played it? Wanda, Peggy would say in a most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. Miss Mason was a class teacher. So Peggy would talk to her very politely. Wanda, she'd say, giving one of her friends a nudge, like she's just pushing that girl. Listen now, what is she going to say? Tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? How many dresses do you have? 100, Wanda would say. 100? Exclaimed all the little girls incredulously. They're not ready to believe it. And little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. 100 dresses, and you wear the same blue faded dress every day? So the girls were very curious, and they would listen to her, they would surround her. Yeah, 100, all lined up, said Wanda. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. What are they like? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. Yeah, all silk, all colors. Velvet too? Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses, Wanda would repeat stolidly. All lined up in my closet. The girls would ask her the same question and she would give the same reply. I have 100 dresses. Where are they? They're in my closet. And yes, they are silk also, they're velvet also, and they're all beautiful colored dresses. Then they would let her go. And then before she'd gone very far, they could not help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. 100 dresses? Obviously, the only dress Wanda had was the blue one she wore every day. They were not ready to believe her. You have 100 dresses and you wear the same dress? So why did she say she had 100? What a story. How many shoes did you say you had? 60 pairs, all lined up in my closet. Do you think Wanda is lying? Do you think Wanda has 100 dresses? Does she have 60 pairs of shoes? Cries of exaggerated politeness greeted this. So they would make fun of her. All alike, shoes are all same because you wear the same dress every day. Maybe you have the same kind of dress. Oh no, every pair is different. All colors, all lined up. Peggy, who had thought of this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friend, were always the first, last to leave. Now Peggy was one of the most popular girls, right? She was pretty, she wore nice dresses. And Maddie was her friend, right? And they would wait there and they were the last to leave. Finally, Wanda would move up the street, her eyes dull and her mouth closed, hitching her left shoulder every now and then in the funny way she had finishing the walk to school alone. Poor thing. And then when they had finished asking a question, the girl would move towards the classroom. Peggy was not really cruel. She protected small children from bullies. See, Peggy was not a bad girl. She would protect the small children from being bullied. Bullied is, yes, when you try to show that you are much stronger and powerful than the others. Okay, right? So, but see, what is she doing? She would protect the small children, but she's bullying her classmate. Right? And she cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. So Peggy was a kind girl. She was a good girl at heart. She wanted to protect children who were being bullied. She did not like cruelty against animals. If anybody had said to her, "Don't you think that is a cruel way to treat Wanda?" she would have been very surprised. Cruel? Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? Anybody could tell that was a lie. Why did she want to lie? And she wasn't just an ordinary person else. Why did she have a name like that? Anyway, they never made her cry. She's saying, "No, Wanda is not ordinary. Why is a name like this? Why is the name Wanda Petronsky? Is it Wanda's fault that her name is like that? No, it's because of the country she belongs to, the community she belongs to, the place she comes from. That is the way people have their names, right? So like, of course, you have people there, they have a difficulty in the pronunciation of our names, right? Indian names. We find the names from other places, right? So maybe from Bengal or Manipur or Gujarat or Karnataka, right? So we find their names different. Like they find our names different, isn't it? So Wanda Petronsky, according to Peggy, it was not an ordinary name. As for Maddie, the business of asking Wanda every day how many dresses and how many hats and how many this and that and she had was bothering her. Maddie herself was poor. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes. Thank goodness she didn't live up on Boggins Heights or have a funny name. Why do you think she thinks this? Why is she happy that she does not live in Boggins Heights? Or her name is not a different name, like Wanda's name. Maddie was not a rich girl. Peggy was there, yes, quite rich, quite popular, wore beautiful dresses to school. But Maddie did not have rich or new clothes. Because she herself also wore hand-me-down, somebody else's clothes. Someone wants to give those clothes away and she would wear those clothes, right? But then why would she tease Wanda? Yes? Why would she tease Wanda? She herself was poor. She wore dresses given by others. And why was she also there teasing Wanda? Not a nice thing. Right? So she is there. Why? Because she was Peggy's friend. And she thought because Peggy is there asking a question and she had to support her friend. She did not want to lose her friendship. Right? Sometimes when Peggy was asking Wanda those questions in that mocking polite voice, Maddie felt embarrassed and studied the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them around and saying nothing herself. Not that she feels sorry for Wanda exactly. See, underline this, she did not feel sorry for Wanda. She would never have paid any attention to Wanda if Peggy had not invented the dresses game. But suppose Peggy and all the others started on her next. She wasn't as poor as Wanda perhaps, but she was poor. Of course, she would have more sense than to say she had 100 dresses. Still, she would not like for them to begin on her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda. Okay. What do you think about Maddie? She's Wanda's friend. She is there, a participant in teasing. She's standing there quietly and allowing Peggy to ask her questions every day. You think she's a part of this wrongdoing? You're supporting someone. You're not stopping someone to do something wrong. Are you encouraging that person? Yes, you are. And why is she doing it? because she feels that if she stops Peggy, Peggy is going to start teasing her maybe. When she comes to know that she is also wearing hand-me-down clothes, that she is also a poor girl. She does not have 100 dresses. She does not have nice clothes like Peggy has. So when you are just standing there, yes, she might lose her friendship. So it's a wrong thing to do. It's a wrong thing. Yes, so supporting a wrong thing means that you are participating in that. Very nice. Very good. Yes, so I got these lovely answers from you all. Right. So when you support something wrong, you are encouraging that. So which is wrong on whose part? Maddie's part. She should stop her friend. Right. And the poor girl is being made uncomfortable every day. Why? Because she does not have an ordinary name like others. That's not her mistake. That means, right? That means what? They are very ignorant. That they are ignorant. They are not aware of these things. Right? Look at these questions here. In what way was Wanda different from the other children? How was she different? She had a name that was different from the others. She was very quiet. She did not talk much. And she would go and sit on, right, or maybe next to the last benches in the classroom and sit quietly in that corner where the noisy boys would sit. Did Wanda have 100 dresses? Do you think she had 100 dresses? Does not seem to. No, she did not seem to have. Why do you think she said she did? Maybe to, yeah, give a reply to Peggy. Maybe it was her way of answering her back and telling her that I'm not afraid of you asking me these questions. You ask me a question, I'm also going to give a reply. We will find out later, where are those 100 dresses? And do they really exist? So why is Maddie embarrassed by the questions Peggy asks Wanda? See, Maddie is embarrassed, but she's not brave enough to stand up against a friend. She is also like Wanda. Yes, she's like Wanda. She's poor. She does not live in a very rich area. And the only thing that is different from Wanda is that she has an ordinary name. If she had a name like Wanda, then she would also have been teased by her friends. Yes. So please make sure that you write down these answers in the book or underline the answers there. Clear? Yes. Today, even though they had been late to school, Maddie was glad she had not to make fun of Wanda. So today they were late and Wanda was not there. Maddie is quite happy. She worked her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly. 8 times 8, let's see. She wished she had the nerve to write Peggy a note. See, Maddie is not a brave girl because she knew she never would have the courage to speak right out to Peggy to say, hey, Peg, let's stop asking Wanda how many dresses she has. How much does it take? Just one sentence you had to say. And it would change so many things. But she did not have that courage. When she finished her arithmetic, she did start a note to Peggy. Note, a small letter. Suddenly she paused and shuddered. Shuddered, she's shivering, thinking of that thought. She pictured herself in the schoolyard, a new target for Peggy and the girls. Peggy might ask her where she got the dress that she had on, and Maddie would have to say it was one of Peggy's old ones that Maddie's mother had tried to disguise with new trimming so no one in room 13 would recognize it. So Maddie is wearing Peggy's clothes. She does not want her friend to know that. And what did Maddie's mother do? She would add a ribbon or a lace or change a little bit so that it would not look old. But she also wore old clothes. And she's imagining herself that if Peggy does not tease Wanda, who is she going to start teasing? She's going to start teasing Peggy. If only Peggy would decide of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda. See, again, having fun. Oh, well, Maddie ran her hand through a short blonde hair as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. What difference did it make? Slowly, Maddie tore into bits the notes she had started. She was Peggy's best friend, and Peggy was the best liked girl in the whole room. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong, she thought. Now, what do you call, you know, like this phenomenon, or you know, like that people of so many different cultures, nationalities, they exist not only in a country, across the world. Yes, can you take, what do you call all these differences that exist here? Have you heard of the word diversity? Yes, have you all heard of the word diversity? So diversity means that understanding that, yes, that there are differences, right? Diversity means that we are different, right? Yes, here he's talking about apartheid also. And we've read about that, how people, they discriminate on the basis of color, on the basis of your nationality, on the basis of your, you can say, the language that you speak. Okay, so let us understand here. Let me see if I'm able to show you what is diversity and inclusion. Okay, can you see the screen? Is it visible to you all? Yes, give me a yes or a no, please. Yes, Harshit, can you see it? Is it visible? Okay. No, if I accept you, I understand you're different. It's not I'm being very brave. It is something that I'm supposed to do. Inclusion is embracing the fact that everyone has value to add. Your difference adds to the beauty, right? No, I don't want to look like others. Just because everyone is speaking that way, behaving that way. No, I appreciate my difference. Right? So even in the classroom, we all have to adopt this, right?
We all mission to build a better working world. As a group,
so here it is, you know, like, yeah, what is inclusion? Inclusion is understanding that everybody is the same, and we have to adapt everyone in this different environment. Okay. Right, so here it was about, you know, like teaching methods that in the school, you know, like whether you're intelligent or whether you're an average child, and we have to adapt that way. But in life, what is inclusion? Understanding that everyone has the right to live and everyone has the right to be proud of their identity. I will not change my appearance. I will not change my name because I want to look like others. Right? So we are blessed with all these differences. Let us be proud of those differences. If we are not able to understand those differences, that means somewhere we are ignorant. So we have to come out of that ignorance. Okay? Right? Yes. So is this clear or not? I hope you all are clear with the principle of